Well, many of you may be familiar with the beautiful stained glass windows at the Thomas Crane Public Library in Quincy Center, but you may not know much more than the fact that they are beautiful. Here is an opportunity for you to get a little history, a little background, a little insight, maybe look at them a little differently with a special presentation. It is a Sunday, September 14th, 2 to 4 p.m., and Matt Bowman will be talking about the John LaFarge windows. He's just completed his thesis in art history at the University of Connecticut, but he joins us here right now to give you a little preview. Matt, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for coming over. Such a young man interested in something so very old.
Yes,
Talk a little bit about yourself, your background, and how you came to this particular
sure.
area.
Well, I'm originally from Chicago, and I went to a small liberal arts college called Augustana College in Rock Island, Illinois. And there I started majoring in science, but I quickly found a love for art history, hence liberal arts school. They kind of introduce you to everything. And so I really got engaged with art history. I decided to go all the way with it and to pursue grad school. And I applied and I ended up out here on the East Coast at the University of Connecticut. So,
Are there any correlations between science and history that you've been able to use, though, throughout your background?
One undergrad professor told me that she had a former student that pursued medical school, and it helped him from all the looking at the objects and paintings and sculpture to see an anatomical form and all those things. So it can help you in that way, although I'm not pursuing science, so that's one connection. But I'm just happy that I can come out to the East Coast and be surrounded by lots of objects and art and be able to think about it academically. So.
Now, art history, were you any particular concentration in art?
American art is what I'm moving to. I started out thinking about European art, but I've really kind of found my niche in late 19th century, mid-19th century, early 20th century American art.
So what brings you here to the Thomas Crane?
Well, I was talking to my advisor when I was trying to figure out my thesis topic. He studied architectural history, and he knew about H.H. Richardson, and he knew about this particular library and its significance architecturally. And I had studied John LaFarge for a long time, and our kind of interest collided, and he ended up being my advisor, and I, from his advice and my own studies, pursued the art inside this library, not just the facade, but the interior with the windows mm-hmm. and the decoration, but focusing mainly on the windows.
What about those windows? What's the story behind them?
There's been little scholarship on them. The little scholarship that there is has said that they're, has talked about their function within the space mm-hmm. as far as stylistically. What their medium is comprised of, the type of glass and things of that nature. But I think that they're more important as far as how they speak towards Thomas Crane or how they memorialize him, and he's obviously the namesake of this library. So I'm looking for more than just talking about the medium and its style. While that's important, I'm going to talk about that. I'm talking more about a theoretical framework to look at these windows, which is an understanding of the man, Thomas Crane, and the way in which these windows act to memorialize him. That's really what my my talk and my thesis is about.
Yeah, it was actually, your thesis is entitled John LaFarge's Stained Glass Windows at the Thomas Crane Library,
mm-hmm.
Old Philosopher, Alpha and Omega. What does that mean?
Well, there's three windows. The one in the middle is the Old Philosopher,
okay.
and then its flanking partners are Alpha and Omega.
Oh.
And as we know, as many patrons will probably know, one was lost, and it was found in 1998, so it completed this three-part set. And so they haven't been around so much as a group. So they're significant for their placement within the library up until 1908 with the Aiken edition. There's a new addition to the wing.
Sure. Yep.
So I talk about, as far as how they're significant to me, I talk about their original placement that we have to envision. We have to pretend like we can see when I give a talk, so we won't be able to see them in their original position since they're moved. But I think that their original positioning is a three-part set, their color, style, and who they memorialize, which I argue is Thomas Crane, is significant to Richardson's interior fitting with the style of the inside and the outside of the library. So
the presentation actually is kind of a two-part presentation. Talk mm-hmm. about how it will actually run that Sunday.
Well, the first part is going to be in a different part of the library, not in the Richardson wing. I'll be in a room with a PowerPoint, and I'll be showing images. I'll be showing images of artwork of stained glass of John LaFarge and his competitor, Lewis Comfort Tiffany, who many are familiar with, who may have his pieces in their home, his lamps, and et cetera. So I'll talk about those and compare them. But I'll also talk about the other important figures, Frederick Law Olmsted, who did the grounds and the exterior, who also designed the first form of Central Park. I'll talk about H.H. Richardson, arguably the most important architect before Frank Lloyd Wright in the United States. Mm. All these men come together to form this beautiful library, which LaFarge took part in to create these windows. So that's in that room, I'm going to talk about the broad history of the glass okay. and these men. And then the second part is moving into the Richardson wing, and I'll be able to take questions from the patrons. I can walk around and talk more about the windows, their connection to the wood carving on the interior that I've talked about in my paper, and the connections to the exterior stonework and glass that I've gathered from some research. So I can just talk off the cuff about those things.
So what do you kind of hope folks take away from your presentation? You know, what is the feeling you want them to have?
I hope that the patrons, whom many have grown up seeing these windows, see them in a new light, see something new when they walk past them. I hope that they're not just, I don't want patrons, not that they already do, but I don't want them to think that these are just generic decorative pieces of stained glass. While they are decorative, they aren't generic. They speak to the patron, Thomas Crane.
Okay, so Quincy residents would enjoy it, but also art history aficionados, if you will.
Yeah, art history buffs would enjoy it. The patrons would enjoy it. Yep. It's for anyone, really of any age could enjoy it. I'm not going to read my thesis from A to B. I'm not going to just read it through. I'm gonna break, and we can take questions, and we can talk. We can just have fun with it.
So. Great. Sounds like a very interesting chat and presentation, and I would guess that a lot of folks who have seen those windows all their lives will look at them in a new light after your presentation.
That's my aim. That's my hope, yeah. Because it's these windows are not necessarily world famous or famous across the United States, but I hope my work will make it maybe more regionally famous at least. So.
Great. Well, thanks for stopping by to share it with us, and I hope you have a great presentation.
Yeah, thanks so much for having me.
You're very welcome. Again, that is Matt Bowman presenting at the Thomas Crane Public Library. It's Sunday, September 14th from 2 to 4 p.m. And if you'd like to learn about this and all of the programs at the library, please visit their website. It's thomascranelibrary.org.